Hello, we are going to be a little bit quay today, as the young kids are saying it, or just trying stuff out. I want to mess around with Linux a little bit again. I miss trying crazy shit out in Linux, so why not try and remove the etc folder? So if you go in here and we look at the file system, and on the computer we have the etc folder. And most of you, if not all of you, know that this is where we go in and customize a lot of things. This is more or less where all the configuration files is. So I don't suspect it will be massively bad, but let's try and remove it and reboot the computer and see what's happening. So if I open up terminal here, and by the way, this is a fresh install of Ubuntu, and I just customized it a little bit. So let's list what's in this directory here. And it's a little bit hard for you guys to see the text here, but let's change that. You see here, we are in the root and we should have etc here. What we're going to do is we're going to remove, which is rm space dash r for recursive, or take all the subfolders and what have you not, and etc. And let's see what's happening in here. I'm stupid. We need to be root. Sudo rm dash r etc. So let's see what happened. We don't have an etc folder anymore. I don't know if you guys can see it, but we don't have an etc folder anymore as we have up here. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to reboot, and then we can see what's going to happen. So if I go in, oh, that's definitely not what I want. Log out, restart. Oh, we get some fail here. Kernel module, user login manager failed. So it looks like we got a kernel panic. Or at least like fail to create time zone changes, set event source, or change event source. No source file or directory. Probably in the etc folder. Fail to start create system users. Fail to start create system users. Oh, it's I'm looking at the both of them here. DRM VM host print if virtual machines blah 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 file host log. I think this is a normal one. So hold until boot process finished up. Yep, terminal playthrough or terminate. Is the word that he's looking for, this stupid guy here. Playmouth boot screen. That's normal. Load kernel module DRM. Now we're going into user login manager. Failed. Failed to start dbus system messages bus. Failed to start user login manager. Air drivers, PC spec is already registered aborting. And then it's starting to, you know, fail to start login manager. It's the same as this one up here. So if you're going to remove the etc folder, you're basically breaking the system. You can't even boot into it. You could probably, like, let's think, how can you recover from this? I just deleted the etc folder, and I kind of want to see, can we actually recover from this? So I booted up a live USB with the Ubuntu 22.04, and I was chrooted into my hard drive here. That's where we have Ubuntu installed, and you can see in here we don't have any etc folder. We have a home folder, but we don't have any etc folder. So I was thinking, can we just copy the etc folder over from this live CD here? So if I go in here and I go up here and I do etc and I do copy, I go back here, I go into my volume that we just deleted everything from, and do, oh, we can't paste in there. Ah, you probably need to be a super user. You do not exist. Oh shit, I need to start up a new terminal. So I started up Nautilus in super user mode here, or root mode, or what you will call it. So let's try again here. So where do we have the etc folder? It should be up, it's there. So let's copy that one. Now we can paste. So as you can see now we have it, and we are still chroot, and I should explain this. What CH root, to think about it, it's kind of like just SSH into a remote system. Instead of just your SSH into a remote system, you're just changing your root folder, your working hard drive, your working Linux system to the directory that you want to do it in, or to the hard drive that you want to work with. So we can do administrative tasks. I could also just copy everything via the file, via the terminal, but I'm lazy, so that's why I did it like this here. So now we have done that. So let's close all of these terminals here and close this terminal, close this one here, close this one here. And it's all done within a live environment. As you guys can see here, it's a live ISO. What happens if I don't go into settings, of course, but I reboot. So when it's starting up now it's starting out from our system that we deleted the etc folder from. Okay, that didn't work. We are now getting some skip ordering cycle found, skip load app armor profile, no additional binary format system. We're getting a lot of systemd problems here. So what I want to try now is I am going to try and copy the etc folder from a working Ubuntu install that I have, put it onto a USB device, booting in with the ISO again, and then copy that folder over. So let's try that and see if that's working. And we are back. So what I did is I copied over a zip file with an etc folder from working Ubuntu GNOME install. Granted, it is customized. And if we go in here, it's this one here. And why do I zip it? Zip it, boy! So, call it a little bit of a tip, I don't know. But I found that if you just copy a folder over, sometimes things in that folder can change permissions on changing working the way they work, you know. So they can be go from being executable to not being executable and stuff like that. And some things just don't want to copy over. But I have noticed that if you compress a folder with everything in it, it keeps everything exactly as it is. So yeah, we need to go back into other locations, and we still have our 27 gigabyte volume. This is the volume or the Ubuntu install that we removed the etc folder on, and we try to copy in the etc folder from the live USB. That didn't work, so we actually need to delete this one again. So let's find a good old terminal. Open up Nautilus in super user mode, as we have here. So first we need to remove the etc folder again. So can we delete it 100%? No, we can't. So it's in the trash can right now. Oh, it is just total deleted, it looks like. So we don't have any etc folder in here anymore. If we go into 13, that's just the name of my USB stick, or 12, don't ask me why. So let's copy this one over, go in here, paste it in here. And yes, you could do this from the command line, but this is a little bit more virtual, and hey, why not just do it in here? It's way easier to just do mouse clicks. Right click and extract here. And we can now move this one to the trash. It's deleted. Do we have anything in the trash can? So what I've done now is I took the etc folder from my working VM with GNOME, Ubuntu GNOME 22.04 in that I use all the time. You know, I use it for videos. I use it to code and mess around with. So it already have everything that the previous version, that the etc folder we deleted, it should have all of those same settings in there, beside, I think, some themes, you know. So it should theoretically be in a working system. Let's close everything down here. Let's restart our VM and see if we can recoup from this. Let's press enter. Oh, something is actually happening right now. Okay, it could not receive the swap file. Could it start? Could this work? Oh, failed to start user spade out of memory. Oh, what happened here? Send app, snapd app armor service. You are in emergency mode. After logging in, type journalctl xb to view system log, systemctl reboot or reboot, systemctl default or exit to boot. Press Control D to continue. starting default target. Yeah, I don't think it's doing anything. Let's try and restart and go into maintenance mode. And we are getting all of these things here. So let's just try and press enter from maintenance. Oh, we are actually in the system right now. But what directory are we in? Root. So we are in emergency mode. So we booted into the system this time. We are now actually in, let's just call it our absolutely simple version of the system. We can't just copy an etc folder over and then say, hey, it's working again. So you are kind of fucked if you delete your etc folder. But if you have an etc folder from an almost identical system and you copy that over, at least you can boot into a recovery kind of mode. But you could, again, log back into the Ubuntu ISO, and then you should have potentially read-write access to the system. We could do that. Okay, so we in the ISO just have to change the display resolution. So if I go in here, can I actually change something in the etc folder in here? So what do I want to bash completion? So if I do this, can I save it? Yeah, I can. This is what I think you I'm not sure, but you probably can recover from this, but it will take you a massive ass fucking time. You need to have an etc folder from a working system that is almost identical to what you did, you know, the system you deleted the etc folder from. And then you need to go in. This is massively fucking complicated. Not complicated, but it takes a long ass time. Then you need to go in and find the configuration files that needs to be altered. You know, probably not the add user here. This is actually a file we need to talk a little bit about at some point. But we need to find, you know, the file that is like host name. What is it here? Test VirtualBox. Host config, you know, we need to find the host or the etc files that are acting up. So if we go into apt here, we probably need to do something about, you know, the source list or something like that. Yeah, we don't want to replace any of them. We probably need to go in and mess around with this a little bit. But if you have the time and you really need that system up and running, which Well, look at it this way. If this happens to you, you, by some fucking miracle, deletes the etc folder. Like, I could probably do it in a fucking drunken state or crazy state with too little sleep. And you need what's on the hard drive. You can just use the ISO from Ubuntu. Put it onto a USB stick, boot from the USB stick, have an external hard drive, or have, you know, copy the files that you need over to a backup USB or over to another hard drive. So let's say it could be pictures, documents, and stuff like that. Maybe some themes that you have downloaded. You can take those and copy those over to an external hard drive or USB stick. And then reinstall your version of Linux, in this case Ubuntu, and then just take that also. You can recoup your data. You can almost do this with any system. Had this been an Arch Linux ISO or hard drive, we could still use the Ubuntu USB key and go and just mount the hard drive and go in there and check what we need. We could probably also see its root into it. I'm not that sure. I think if you change the root directory, it needs to be to a similar system. So I think that's the case. I'm not sure. Meaning that you probably can't do it for see its root from Ubuntu into Arch. But you can mount the Arch hard drive. Look at it a little bit like we're taking it out of the computer, putting into a hard disk enclosure and mounting it via the USB stick. That's basically what we're doing here. We're just mounting the hard drive. So as long as you have access to the hard drive, you can get your data. So would you want to do this? Probably not. If this happens, if you delete your etc folder and drunken rage or something like that, your best bet is to just start up a live USB session, download, copy, the things over that you need, and then reinstall Linux. Anyway, this was just a little bit of fun. See you later. Bye-bye.